in this teachers training program. So before starting the next session, I would like to read the profile of our next speaker. Our next speaker and expert is Dr. Saurabh Pratap. He is currently assistant professor in IIT BHU. He completed his BTech from Institute of Engineering and Technology from 2004 to 2008, then completed MTech program in Design and Production from National Institute of Technology Durgapur from 2009 to 2011, and PhD in Industrial and System Engineering from Indian Institute of Technology Kharagpur from 2011 to 2016. He has a vast professional experience, which includes experience as assistant professor in PDPM IIT DM Jabalpur. Then he has a postdoc experience in Hong Kong University and research associate and research senior research fellowship experience in IIT Kharagpur. He has an experience of guest PhD in EPFL, Lausanne, Switzerland. Also the research scholar and research experience in IIT Kharagpur. He worked as an assistant professor in NIEC Delhi and as a lecturer in MPEC Kanpur. So he has a vast professional experience. His research area includes supply chain network design and modeling, operations research application in production and transport and logistics system. His teaching interests are operation management, supply chain management, operation research, DCN modeling, and intelligent manufacturing. He has published several research paper in international journals, which is SCI Index, and he is also in the editorial board and also the reviewer of many reputed journals. His research collaborations include he is associated with Hong Kong University as well as Geneva, Switzerland University, and he has also research collaboration with IIT Kharagpur. Awards and achievements are scholarship awarded by Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Lausanne, IIT Kharagpur joint program, and also received the Distinguished Best Faculty Award for academic year in 2009. He has a proficiency in many softwares like MATLAB, advanced softwares like SAS, CP, LEX, and other designing softwares. He has attended many STTPs and many workshops and conferences. So with this profile and with this introduction, I would like to request, sir, kindly proceed the session.
Thank you, Nitin. First of all, am I audible, Nitin?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
And my slide is visible to you or not?
No, my sir. Slide. Currently, it is not visible. Your slide is not visible, sir, right now.
Just a minute. Just a minute.
Sure, sir, sure.
Now is it visible?
Yes, sir, now it is visible, sir.
Okay. Sorry. So Today I will discuss the application of big data to improve the system. Let us assume for some e-commerce platform or some online ERP system. So how can we use the big data? So these are the outlines of my presentation. First of all, I will introduce about the big data definition, the frame. Then after a case study related to one company, how we can introduce some new business model. Then if you want to generate or manage the revenue through big data for some e-commerce company, then how can we do big data and the operations, and some little bit summary. So actually nowadays there are three trends which are basically we are using in a company. That one is our digitization and another one is analytics, and third one is automation. So in digitization, whenever we have a lot of data, we have a data, and maybe the data in the form of a structured way or unstructured way. So, and maybe we have a low data, and obviously if we are storing or we are working on a data, there will be a some cost associated with the data. And then after analytics, so there will be number of techniques associated with the analytics, just like a predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics, descriptive analytics, and some maybe by the use of data we have to diagnose the issue. So for that there will be some computational activity will also occur. So that will be analytics. And after that, the third trend is automation. Most of the company is now moving towards the automation, just like a cloud driven scalability, for just like advanced business rule system. So whenever we use these trends, we always follow these four steps. These are the major four steps: prescriptive, predictive, diagnostic, and the descriptive. We will see one by one how does it play an important role in the analytics. So this is a one I'm showing one survey that is conducted by one multinational company. So how we can just like a, how we can use the technology in different aspects. So from the survey, the 86% of the employee, they believe that digital platform will be used to share the assets and create an ecosystem. So the 86% of the employee, they believe on the digital platform, and 90% of the employees, they believe in the workforce. They believe how to how to improve the skills and how to add new skill in the company. So whenever we add new skill, just like a, because analytics and automation will automatically will occur. So whenever we add some skill, it will beneficial for the company. So 90% of the employee believe in this survey. 94% of the employees they are favor in planning to invest in visibility and collaboration. They believe that if we collaborate or if we move toward the collaborate for the next 5 years, it will be more efficient, it will be more beneficial for the company. Eighty-five percent of the employees, they believe in the big data analytics and automation. they believe that these techniques means analytics and automation, it increase the profit, or it increase the profit, even the it reduce the cost also, reduce the cost of means production cost also. So we can say that by considering these two factors, we can improve the customer satisfaction also, we can improve the customer experience also.
Sir, sorry to disturb you.
Yeah.
Sir, have you changed the slide, sir? Because we are able to see it.
Are you able to
currently
the slide new technology?
Currently, sir, actually we are seeing only the first slide, sir.
Oh, how is it possible? Now?
Yes, yes. Now we can see, sir.
Okay. So 97% of the employees, they dedicated over the half of the budget. They believe that the budget is an important aspect for the new technology. So whenever we focus on the budget, definitely our technology in the supply chain will also affect. So 97% of the employees, they believe in this phenomena. Now, what is big data analytics? Big data is, we can say, it is a phenomena of whenever we have a large data set. Okay, whenever we have a large data set, but we don't know how to use these data sets. So we can say big data analytics is an open complex process of examining the big data to uncover the information. Means there will be some hidden information, so we have to uncover that information, we have to correlate the information, we have to identify, we have to identify